Hey guys, this is Faye from Feisworld. I'm excited to share a brand new feature from Sonix.ai. It's a feature that many people still don't know, which is how to repurpose your podcast interviews, your livestream videos, get the transcript, but you don't stop there because you can now create video clips or audio clips very easily. You can then share those video and audio clips on multiple platforms, further expose your content, your brand, your show to others. Coming up. Hey guys, this is Faye from Feisworld Media, and here I'm demonstrating a new feature by Sonix.ai. We have been using Sonix for video and audio content transcriptions for a little while, and here I'm showcasing the Enabled Disabled podcast, and this is our host Gustavo Serafini with our first guest on the show, BJ Miller from Metal Health. And this feature is all about creating video clips. If you have been following us for a little while, you know I'm all about content repurposing. So here I'm going to scroll through the transcripts, and I remember there's a segment I love very much. So I like the entire paragraph. All I have to do is highlight it, use this little scissor icon, and you have the option to make this an audio-only clip, but in my case, I would like a video clip. And here, remember that you selected the text, but here you can also make edits as you need to, such as, you know, changing a period or, you know, updating the text if you want to. So now highlight, click scissor, create video clip. Okay, looks like the video clip is done. So because my segment was longer, it took about 3 to 4 minutes. I had to step away because I got a little bored. So if your clip is much shorter, I'm sure it won't be as long. Now I have the option to download the file or just preview the clip in a new tab. So let's take a look. Here's my new clip. Now I can download the file. That took just a couple of seconds or so. And here's my file. I can rename it. It's only 1.6 megabytes. So let me play that. So it's roughly a minute and 19 seconds. There's also a clip where I can just share the video directly. So if I share the clip via the URL, people are able to get on this page, as you can see, with some minimum graphics and animation in the background. And people are able to basically see right here, and they can change the volume, mute it if they need to. Let's see what happens if I try to share it on Twitter or LinkedIn. I can just post this link. I have that. I can tag people. There's no preview necessarily. So that's my experience. I think it's really cool. And another thing worth mentioning is I know a lot of us are sharing these files on social media. Therefore, it's important to know how long it is. So as you're clipping and looking at these things, there isn't going to be a summary right away, even though I would recommend Sonix to consider that. As I highlight, it tells me how long this segment is. Since it doesn't tell me, what you can do, however, is to look at the segments such as the minute mark 49:43, and this is 51:19. So that gives you a rough idea of how long this segment is. So in this case, it's longer than a minute. So if you clip something like this, chances are it's probably within a minute. You can sort of eyeball this. So that's one thing I want to mention, because right now on social media, there's so many constraints in terms of how long a segment needs to be, you know, such as Instagram story versus YouTube short versus versus TikTok. So it's all over the place. Speaking of which, we did develop youtuberkit.com. Inside, we do have a social media guideline and social media Bible that gives you a matrix of how long you need to create these videos for. Lastly, I would say that wouldn't it be nice for you to take a look at all these clips you created from within your transcript? There is a way to do that. Simply go to File and Clips Created. You go there and you're going to see all the clips you've ever created. Right now, I only have one, and by clicking on the clip, I'm able to preview everything. I'm able to delete it, rename it, do whatever you need to do. So I hope you find this helpful. This is again Faye. I have other tutorials on transcription services. I had an original one for Sonix.ai as well. So definitely go ahead and check it out. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.